Welcome to today's episode of Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, I'll scratch an itch I've had for a long time. Namely that in headers in your table, it's possible to sort either ascending or descending. But once you've sorted, you cannot go back to the sorting that your input model provided. Okay, so to understand the problem that we're trying to solve here, please have a look at this application. You can see I got a table here with a bunch of columns, monkeys, apple, compilers, gizmos, and bars. You might ask yourself, what is this table really about? Absolutely nothing. I just made it up, just five random columns with a bunch of random data in. But there's one thing that is absolutely not random in this one, and that's the column over here. That's the input model that provides this. Okay, observe what happens if I click on the compilers. You can see my compilers get sorted here in ascending mode. And if I click on it again, it'll be sorted in descending mode. And observe that my headers over here, because this is not a column, this is my headers. Observe that they, of course, get sorted together with the rows. But if I now want to go back to see my data unsorted, for whatever that means, there's no way that I can click over here or something to get that back. And that's what we're trying to solve in this very video. See, the problem comes from QTableView or QHeaderView that do not have this possibility of going tri-state, sorted, ascending, sorting, descended, unsorted. And that's what we'll try to add here. Let me show you the source code for this. But first, let me show you what it looks like when it's actually working. I've now restarted my application. And in this restarted version, there's a small modification. I'll show you what it looks like. Sorting my compilers, ascending. Sorting my compilers, descending. Now, unsorting my compilers. This time, I'll do it once more and observe the rows over here, what they look like. That's my input model that you can see the sorting order there. So sorting it. And it's a random numbers here because now it's sorted by this one here. Sorting it ascending, well, descending. And you can see again, random stuff here, but that's because of the sorting. And when I click there a third time, we go back to the input model unsorted. I can, of course, click other columns here, just as we usually do. And if I'm in descending and I click this one here, then we'll start doing ascending over there. Before I show you the code and share it with you for free, please do accept that this code is good enough for me. I'm actually using it in an in-house product, but it might not be library quality where there is absolutely no corner cases unhandled. So if you find such a corner case, do send me a patch and I'll share it with the rest of the viewers. Just underneath my beautiful face, you can find a link to where you download this source code. So I'm not going to go into all the core details of how every single line of code works in here. We start out in our main.cpp. As you can see, I am creating the model. I do that from 37 to 50 here. That is just setting up a model that we can use to display something. I create a sort filter proxy model, and I use that model on my view. That's the setup of things. I have a few more things in here so that I can demonstrate that it's actually working pretty well. This line here is the magic line. I simply instantiate an adapter and specify the view so that you can see it in action. As you'll see, the adapter is actually an implementation of an event filter. And just a very short summary of what an event filter is. An event filter is an object that gets to hear all the events in the system before the object himself hear it. So what you do is that you install the event filter on an object, and then the event filter will have its event filter method executed before the appropriate, say, mouse press, mouse move, whatever, event handler on the object gets executed. Okay, the header sorting adapter class looks exactly like this. It's a subclass of QObject. It implements the event filter method, which is what makes it an event filter. It, in its constructor, takes a QTableView, which is the table view that it operates on. And it has some instance variables down here. We'll see those a bit later, or you can read up on it yourself. The constructor looks like this. It fetches the horizontal header of the table. That's a queue header view. And then on that, it does three things, three magic things. First, it sets the sorting indicator to be ascending on column number minus one. Well, our column start at column zero. So column number minus one is a special case, actually an undocumented feature of QTableView that tells if we set the sorting order to be on or sort on column minus one, then it will show the underlying model unsorted. So we start out showing it unsorted. We hide the sorting indicator. And finally, we go to the header view, we ask for its viewport and install ourselves as an event filter on this object. So as I stated before, this is good enough for me code, not library worthwhile. And one thing you might notice here is that my adapter takes a table view as a parameter. It doesn't take a tree view or a queue abstract item view. It takes a table view, but it shouldn't be all that much additional work for you. If you want this on a tree view, I simply haven't tested it. So therefore I do not support that feature in my version. Again, if you implement it and you get it working really, really well, do send me a patch and I'll share it with the rest of the viewers. Let's get to the part where all the magic happens. It's down in the event filter. And I will not bother you with all the gory details of what my event filter does. But you can see I test on the actual type of the event that comes in. If it's a mouse press, do something. If it's a mouse move, do something. And finally, down here, we have the mouse release. And that's where the magic happens. The other two part is to support this feature that I can actually reorder my columns. So I can take my apples and move them between the gizmos and the bars. For that feature, I need the other two instances. The magic happens here in my mouse button release. You can see the state machine on line 76 to line 85. The first stage of the state machine is what we have here. If my column that I'm currently sorting by is different from the column I just clicked on, that means I'm moving from outside into the state where I want to sort ascending. The code looks like this. I ask my sorting indicator or my header to sort by this given column and in ascending order. My header view will then tell the actual proxy underneath to do the actual sorting. And I also tell it to show the sort indicator because we might not even show it. That's state number one. Then if I'm showing sorting, that's what you can see here. I'm showing sorting already on the given column. Then I want to go to the state where I'm showing it in descending order. And finally, if I'm showing it in descending order, then I want to go back to the unsorted. And that's this line of magic here. The minus one here is the key thing. I want my header to sort by column minus one. Remember, that means send the input model through without any sorting. And I hide my sorting indicator. This special line here is to make sure that it actually behaves as much as possible as the original queue header view. And therefore, I must make sure that it actually emits the section clicked. And I return true. I'm an event filter. The event filter tells usually just let the, or well, depending on the event filter, but this particular event filter will not let the mouse press onto the actual header view. If it did, then the header view would start toggling the sorting itself. Now, the only part that is left is that you click on the show details below and you download the code so you can play with it and possibly even use it in your own project. Your users will value that you can go back to the original sorting, I'm sure. I'm Jesper Pedersen. You've been watching Qt Widgets and More.